So I'm writing a 64 gig file onto this Samsung 870 Evo SSD. So this is a 1 TB model, as I did in my as I showed you in my previous video. So, and I also mentioned that this one has a few about 42 gig cache, so the speeds should be pretty consistent up till like this is 32 gig mark, and this is around this is 42 gig mark. So let's see how are the speeds. Like the top speeds of this SSD is like over this interface, like serial ATA interface, it is like 550 writes and speeds maximum. So let's see, over here we see 500 writes. For some reason it's 468 over here, but yeah. So I'm gonna fast forward how this performs. Looking at this and this, let's see how it goes. It's pretty consistent up till now. Here it is going. Recording. Speeds didn't drop surprisingly. It means that the cache is holding pretty well and it's slowly like transferring to the other memory. So that's pretty good. And it means that it can work pretty good under very heavy workloads and it would not disappoint you. So that's really good, especially like when you're recording high like very high speed demanding tasks, like something like recording an 8K video or something similar. So the read speeds are also pretty consistent, and here we can see it's 500, 498, 550 max, 559. So the graph tells it all, and the SSD is 98%, 99% using 497. So that's pretty good. I wanted to stress test this SSD, so here we are, we're doing it. So on the back end, not much is running, it's just WhatsApp, maybe Excel. Yeah, it is Excel. And that should give you a pretty good idea how reliable this SSD actually is. So the software I'm using is AJA System Test, and here we can actually do pretty different stuff over here. Right now it's 8-bit. Let me show you the settings real quick. It's 5K read, 64 gig test file size, and codec type 8-bit, RGBA, target disk, doesn't matter. And settings, and here we're about to finish this test, and that should be a good idea for you to see how it will perform for you as well. But the real world tests are pretty good. These are benchmarks, but it still gives you a really good idea of how it would perform while you're doing your stuff. So here it is, it's now back at normal. The usage is dropped to 1% and the test is finished. So yeah, that's pretty much it for today, and I hope you like this video. So then like, share and subscribe and click on the notification bell, and I guess I'll see you in the next one. Peace.